my soul. Love Jesus. My soul.
Approval, support, or liking for someone or something. It
also is defined for an act of kindness beyond what is due or usual. But the old mothers in my church would say that favor simply means that the hand of God is on your life.
Yes, sir.
But my brothers and sisters, I've come to the realization that even though favor is not fair, God is still good.
Yeah.
Anybody testify to that? That even when I am going through, I give my money like I'm supposed to. I come to Bible study. I come to prayer meeting. I come to service on Sunday morning. Not only do I show up for Sunday morning service, I'm there for even Sunday school. But still, every time I turn around, the enemy is always in something. If it's not one thing, it is another. But I thank God that even though favor is not fair, God is still good.
Yes.
I realize, my brothers and sisters, that favor does one crucial thing. It attracts things. It attracts not only good things, but bad things. Some of the good things are blessings. It attracts promotions. It attracts increase. But not only that, it attracts scandals. It attracts heartache. It attracts lies. It attracts mess. It attracts pettiness. And my brothers and sisters, as I've already stated, even though I am favored, I still go through, but I thank God that He is still good.
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, as we look at this text, and I promise you, I will be out of your way in the next 5 minutes. Now, we look at the text and we find here that our writer is a man that we all know and love by the name of David.
Right.
We all know who David was. David, the songwriter. David, the one that was after God's own heart. David, ladies and gentlemen, Jesse's youngest boy, the one that when the man of God came to anoint the next king was overlooked. And my brothers and sisters, if I can stop there for a moment and tell everybody that God is calling two types of people in this season, Apostle Harrell, I realize that God is calling one those that have been overlooked. Ladies and gentlemen, we realize that David was overlooked by all of his brothers. When the man of God came to Jesse's house, Jesse presented all of his sons and said, "This one looks like a king. He walks like a king. He talks like a king." But can I tell two or three people here on tonight that God is not going after those that look the part, but He is going after the ones that have been going through, the ones that have gone through the turmoil, the ones that have gone through the fire. I wish I had two or three people that have talked back to me and say, "I am called because I've been through."
All right.
Is calling Sabitha, and he also is calling those that are working. What are you talking about, Belle? When the man of God came to Jesse's house, David was out in the field attending to his father's sheep still. Belle, I don't understand what you're saying. God has an assignment for each and every one of us, but He will find you not to being lazy, but God will find you while you are already making preparation for the assignment that He has called you to. Look at somebody for the first time on tonight and say, "Neighbor, I'm already working." We look at the text over the last 3 minutes that I have left. We realize that even though I am favored, I go through. But I'm so glad, Minister Shamel, that the Lord is my shepherd. My brothers and sisters, I'm so glad that God is good at His job, because I've come to the realization that even when I am going through, God is my shepherd. And even when it seems as if I'm ready to throw in the towel and give up, God is still good at His job, and He is still a good shepherd. My brothers and sisters, lastly, as I close here, reminding of a story. There was a woman that came to church every would get up and testify and say, Lord, I thank you for my new car. And after service was over, she would walk down the steps of the church and catch the bus. The following week, she would get up and testify again as she did the following, the previous week. And she said, Lord, I thank you for my new car. And after service was over, she walked down the steps and got on the bus.